Hi everybody, today I will be doing system test number 4, series 3 on my Silent Night 6808 addressable fire alarm system. Let's go ahead and get started. And so, this is a non-requested system test, and it's going to be a pretty interesting setup. And so, for the notification appliances today, right up here for NAC1 I have my system sensor P2RH-LF. Strobe is set on 135 candela, and that's a pretty bright strobe, by the way. And then coming over here, I have my system sensor L series set on high volume, code 3, and the strobe's on 15 candela. That and that are both on system sensor sync, but I have another notification appliance I want to show you. Coming right up here, I have a system sensor PC2RL-LF. Yes, I now have a ceiling mount low frequency sounder strobe. And I got this for a pretty good deal off eBay. But coming up beside that, notice I now have a sounder base on the heat detector, but this is not a B200SR sounder base like what's on my firelight panel. This is actually an intelligent B200S sounder base. And this is model number of this is B200S-LF. This type of sounder base does not work on my firelight panel, but it does, however, work on my Silent Night panel, which I'm pretty happy with. And I will be setting this off today with a hairdryer in this system test. Coming right down here, sorry if you can't see that very good because of the sun glaring. But for the first conventional pull station today, I have my Silent Night SD500 PSDA. It's addressable, but I'm using it as conventional because I'm able to bypass the module on it. Coming down here underneath the stopper, I have my Firelight BG12L. As part of the system test today, we will be activating the SK photo with some smoke saber. And for our addressable pull station today, we will be pulling the SK pull DA. Alright, and for the VEC2550 today, I have it set on slow whoop, and the voice message is enabled in this system test. And before we start, we are going to make one more announcement over the microphone, saying that we are about to begin.
Attention in the building, attention in the building. We will be testing the life and safety system at this time. Again, we will be testing the life and safety system at this time. This is only a test. There is no need to evacuate. Please disregard all signals at this time until further notice. Thank you for your cooperation.
As I mentioned earlier, all the notification devices are on system sensor sync, so the strobes will continue to flash after I silence the system. To start off today's system test, we're going to go ahead and pull the Silent Night SK Pull DA. Headphone users, I recommend you please turn down your volume. Here we go, in 3, 2, 1. As you can see, the strobes on the P2RH-LF and the P2RL continue to flash since, again, they're on system sensor sync. And the strobe on the L-series low-frequency sounder continues to flash as well. And again, here's the strobe on the SPSR still going. Now we're going to reactivate the system again by pulling the SD500 PSDA. Here we go.
Attention
now we're gonna reset the pull stations. So what I'm gonna do is gonna take my silent night key. Don't know if you can see that. Gonna foot the handle back up. Put it back into place just like that. Now for the SK pull DA. Just gonna take my silent night key. And I'm gonna surround this, open it back up just like that. Now I'm gonna go into the main fire alarm control panel. I'm gonna hit system reset. All right, next up, we will reactivate the system again by pulling the Firelight BG-12L. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Here's the strobes going again. And now I'm going to go into the panel again. I'm going to hit system reset. All right, now we move on to the detectors. And first up, we will activate the B200 SLF with the heat detector using my hair dryer. So I'm just gonna hold it up to here. It'll take about 45 seconds and then it'll go ahead and activate. Here we go, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. As you can see, I did make the intelligent low frequency sounder base silenceable, and it's only set to go off when the head on it is activated. And I did that by creating a separate zone for the intelligent sounder base and assigning the detector head to that zone. All right, next up, reactivate the system again by spraying some smoke saver at the SK photo. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Now I'm going to go into the panel again. I'm going to hit system reset. Right, now for the supervisory system. So for the supervisory system today, we will be activating the Edwards 278A-REL. Here we go. I'm just going to lift up the cover and I'm going to pull the pull station in 3, 2, 1. to reset the Edwards 278A REL. I'm just going to take my Cat 45 key, put the switch down like that, pull it back up. And now I'm going to go into the main fire alarm control panel and I'm going to hit system reset. All right, and for the final part of the system test, we're just going to end off by pressing the drill button. And so all the notification appliances will be out of sync. And I also programmed the sounder base to activate in fire drill mode as well. So you will hear that go off. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Press the drill button and press enter. Before we end our system test, we'll make one more announcement over the microphone saying that we have finished.
Attention in the building, attention in the building. We have finished testing the life and safety system at this time. Again, we have finished testing the life and safety system at this time. If you hear any fire signals from this point forward, please evacuate to your nearest assembly point. Again, if you hear any fire signals from this point forward, please evacuate to your nearest assembly point. Thank you for your cooperation, and I hope you all have a great day.
All right, everybody, this is going to do it for system test number 4, series 3 of my Silentlight 6808 addressable fire alarm system. Everybody, comment down below what you think of the video, and be sure to rate and subscribe.